Hey, darlings, it's Gwen. I'm here to do a reading for the collective. I wanted to tune into the Fairy Oracle deck today. Welcome if this is the first time that you're joining me. Yay, I'm so glad you found me. To my followers and subscribers, I love you guys. I love you, love you, love you. Let's get right into it today. I've got some dragon's blood, incense burning for the collective. We're in Aries season, full of fire and passion, aren't we? And that's definitely an incense that is of the element of fire and dragon. I'll pull some dragon wisdom card. Dragon's blood is beautiful for protection, okay, as well. So it was interesting when I lit my palo, though, my palo santo here. It's a smaller piece that I am one to like to burn it down to nothing, okay, and then I'll put my little pieces into my cauldron and make a little fire. I've got a little cauldron here. Let me show you all my witchy stuff. See? I got my little cauldron here where I put my ashes and, you know, whatnot, the ends of my palo in there, and then I'll burn it and have a little. So cauldron symbolism is already coming out in this reading today, but why I was telling you about that, yes, I have bigger sticks than this, and why I wanted to burn the end of this. Okay. It's purposeful in this message today is what I'm saying. I burnt my finger. I was like, ow, prick. That's what I said. So, the end of this lesson might be a little prickly. That's all I'm saying. Okay, so let's see what the fae had to say today. Give me some love down below. Reach out to me if you want some personal private messages. Okay. I am booking those. You can follow me on Instagram or on Facebook. I'm Mystic Gwen there. And I love you guys. Thanks for the good karma donations. Thanks for the comments. Thanks for watching the video all the way through. Okay, so what do we got for the collective on the 10th? Faye, what do you want to... I haven't used this deck in so long. Wow, that one flew out. Let me move my palo here real quick. Ooh, you in daydreaming mode? Yeah, it's Neptune messing with us. I know it is. Far, far away. Far, far away. This is the card of, like, even people might say around you, like, are you here? Where are you? Often, la-la land, dreamland. This is creative daydreaming. And this is a beautiful month for setting intentions with two new moons, the one at the beginning of the month, one at the end of the month with an eclipse. Okay, so yeah, she sits on top of this rune here, this relic rune, whatever you want to call it, and she's manifesting her future in deep thought, introspection. Card 30, it's a three, so mind, body, spirit, connection with the ascended masters, creation. Okay. What else here? I see the spiral there. So the spiral is about, actually, you know, you could be really in a time of introspection about your own patterns and how to move forward, you know, how to let go, how to surrender, how to step into the new. There's a lot of creative energy flowing right now. Okay. Ideas coming, creative inspiration, where you... Maybe you felt stuck before, like, it's moving, we're in that energy of moving forward. And figuring out the riddle Fisher. Yeah, putting the puzzle pieces together. This connection with water. Now they're going to give you another three. Sunny beaches. Yeah. 3-3 right there. They're here. Your ascended masters are with you. Divination, water divination. It comes out with a riddle fisher. Divination, seeking out and finding answers. So when I say water divination, okay, look it up. You curious? Look it up. It's not something that I do yet that I've remembered. But it's fascinating learning all different forms of magic and tools that we have to communicate with the divine and with our higher self. Right? And so the magician in each one of us, I feel like that was Merlin. Anyways, we'll see he comes out because he's in the deck. Water divination, like scrying into water, okay? Scrying, like focusing, looking at the water and seeing if any images come up. You could even drop like colored, they're showing me in a visual here, colored, like food coloring or whatever, in a bowl of water and drop that in there and see what formulates, or possibly even wax with that. I don't know. Like, it seems like it, there's a look up water divination because it's showing it here. Connection with the water is connection with your emotions. Okay. What are your emotions telling you? What piece of the puzzle is that? Okay. Seeking out and finding answers. What was lost is now found. You're finding yourself. You're finding that you're the creator. Maybe you have felt lost in a situation. You felt like you lost a part of yourself. That's the riddle picture. It's like figuring it out, okay? All right. Far, far away, she also wants me to say, this is denoting travel. Far, far away. I'm not even saying that. What am I saying that like? Far, far away. Oh, that's from Forrest Gump. Oh, God, the little girl. Jenny. Said, oh, take me far, far. How she was saying that prayer. Oh, shah. Okay. Yeah, because you feel lost where you're at right now. Okay? Crystal magic. Reverse. Yeah, that's talking about. When it's in the upright, it's you see yourself in everything. Right? You see your own magic. You see your connection with the world, with the relation, in the relationships. You see healing, and you know, that's what the crystal is. This crystal grows from the earth, connection to earth, you know, feeling grounded and centered and open to receiving, but it's reverse. So where you're guarding your emotions. Is this another three? Holy shit balls now. Okay. It is 21 is a 3, 3, 3, 3. Angel number 3, 3, 3 here today. That is highly powerful number. Creation, dawn, the beginning. Let go. Surrender to this healing. Okay? There's a need to hold on to something of the past, need to hold on to emotions of the past, trauma of the past, trying to figure out the fucking answers. All of that will come if you let go. If you know that you are your own healer, that it's all happening in divine timing. You just, like, maybe in the situation that you're in, you just don't understand. You don't understand. You don't feel seen. Is with the crystal magic is... reversed. Knowledge means change. Purple energy. Moon in the background there. Okay? This is connection with your lunar being. Your intuitive, which is your feelings. Okay? And you're awakened. You know, the butterflies speak to transformation. Okay? Once was innocent, knowledge means change now. You're moving forward with the wisdom that you are the creator, that you are powerful, that you are sovereign, okay, a magical being. Car 28, which is a 10. Today's the 10th. 10-10 now for you. 10-10, that's an angel number again. And it may be just a return again, like solace. You connecting with you and your inner child is what this shows. Okay? Beautiful. Nurturing your wounds, licking your wounds. Yeah, this is what I see. And then this premonition coming, galactic communication. Woo-wee! Visions, I'm telling you, stardust. She's up there in the sky and she's got a gargoyle sitting at her side. Beginnings and endings. We're afraid to let go sometimes. We're so used to a certain way. It's scary. Change is scary. Yes, I'm... You'd think I'd be more used to it being a Gemini, but nah. Yeah. Okay, so I'm just going to leave those three fairies out today. I like that three number now. Power of three coming up into this reading today. Effin' love it. Okay. So now we're going to get some of these heart and soul cards. I've been adding these types of readings to the channel. Check them out. They're timeless. I call them heart and soul angel messages. I did a pick an angel, like pick a pile reading. And for some very powerful channel messages that came through there. So check those out. May just be exactly what you need to hear. I'm going to start doing them for all of the signs individually as well. I'm very weird with this shuffle here. It's very robotic. Did you see that? Like chunky robot. I like this. Was I talking about? Man, look at that pop of light. This is an explosion. This is you becoming a star. This is you and your rebirth. Oh, wow. I see so much light and power coming from this card. Wow. Your inner light lit fuck up. Solar energy here. It's talking about you're afraid of letting go. We'll get into that in a minute. I've already talked about that. Here are these angel cards confirming it. That's why the crystal magic was reversed. Do you believe in the power of crystals? Right? Like, we've been using crystals and the technology, you know, with technology, and it's, you know, we know as a culture that the crystal is healing. Okay? And what this fairy is saying here in this card is that, you know, because there's pictures of herself, there's pictures of people inside these crystal points. Like, you are your own healer. You are as powerful as a crystal. And it's time to nurture your spirit, your soul, your body, and create anew. It's always darkest right before the dawn, I hear. In the darkness, we are in creation mode. Y'all, whoa, look at that. I'm telling you, some bright future ahead. Power, solar energy, inner expansion, heart expansion, solar plexus healed, feeling confident in your own skin. Let's talk about this one first, and then the fire energy coming in here with that as well. You're afraid to let go of something that is no longer working for you. There is a deep sense of duty or guilt, and you feel like you don't have a choice. The reality is that you do, and ultimately doing what you know feels right in your heart will be best for all concerned. Okay? I don't think I need to elaborate. It said everything I need to say there. From your soul's perspective, this life is just a page in the never-ending story. You're the author of this chapter. Okay? This is just a chapter. Mm-hmm. The never-ending story. La 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 la. Come on, watch that movie again, you know? From your soul's perspective, this life is just a page in the never-ending story where you, and oh, they're saying it's a page, and I was saying it's a chapter. Maybe it's been a chapter. You're like, I am so ready to flip this fucking page into a new chapter, right? Okay. Let me start over. How many times am I going to start over? Ah, maybe that's a message here, too. How many times do I got to start over? Resonates for me. From your soul's perspective, this life is just a page in the never-ending story where you and those around you all have a specific role to play. Yet remember, this role is not the real you, for you are much more than your personality and current circumstances. Your true immortal self cannot be defined. Yes, I love that. Chin up, crown on, right? Like, you cannot be defined. That's why I don't like labels. Don't put a label on me. Okay. I think that's really why, like, I've always been that way. I really didn't want to be labeled, and so I therefore wouldn't join groups, organizations, cliques. I wasn't a part of a group, clique, blah, 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 blah. Delight. Look at this pop of light expansion. I love it. Within the transcendental realm of your soul, there are endless universes, each inconceivably vast and at the same time inconceivably small. Even in the tiniest particle of subatomic matter, there is endless expansion. Creation is a cosmic motion picture in which you are both the director and the actor. Writing a book, writing a screenplay, you're the director. I said this yesterday in the reading. You are the actor and you are also the director. And you produce it. And you star in it. Change your fucking perspective to that. Please. I'm talking to myself too. Okay. Creation is a cosmic motion picture in which you are both director and actor. Look within and express outwardly the endless waves of love within you. May your love embrace the earth and fill all of creation. Oh, I love it. I love it. I love it. We're going to get some tarot real quick because I want to clarify these fairy cards for the collective. Talk to me about this far, far away. Let me shuffle this up a little bit. Shuffle, shuffle, shuffle. I love my new heart and soul cards. Tricky. All right. For the collective, this far, far away, let's clarify this. Thank you, Faye, for the synchronistic numbers, for the beautiful messages that came through, darlings. Yes, yes, yes. I love you guys. Far, far away. Woo-wee. That one just floated out like a butterfly, it felt. It was so soft when it landed in my lap. What is it? Oh, the moon reversed. Very, very nice. I like it reversed. You know what that means? The mystery, the illusion, the missing puzzle pieces, the fear. It's called, it's bye-bye. We're releasing it. Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Mm-hmm. Or it's something's coming to the light. That's the moon reversed. Cancer energy coming out could be speaking to the sign of Cancer. Now I've got the Six of Swords. Okay. See here, some divine protection almost. Okay. This guy on the motorcycle with a sidecar here. This is speaks to travel, leaving a situation behind. There's a trusty hand on this shoulder, this mother and this child here. Yeah. Leaving a situation behind. They look in fear, the mother and child. This masculine energy very much feels like a trustworthy energy. There's two swords in the path. There could be some obstacles, some blocks. Okay. What is, why is the riddle fisher here? Seeking out and finding answers, water divination, connection with your emotions. What's lost is now found. You're finding your worth. Queen of Pentacles. A balancing that's happening within you. Or a divine connection. That's the Hierophant. Card 5. It's a change. It's a spiritual connection. A sacred marriage. A teacher-student role. Rainbow energy. Surrounding yourself with richness again in life. Okay. Happy. This is the happy wife. Home foundations. Okay. And blessings. She's such a green robe and oh, so beautiful. What else? And happiness. Ten of Cups. Oh, look at that double rainbow energy. Emotional fulfillment. Oh, wow. I love it. And a marriage. With the that's meant that was like it's a very beautiful spiritual connection. I like to see these cups and these pentacles here. Hail to the yes. Hail to the yes for the collective. Once you fucking let go, why are you holding on to that shit from the past? The guilt, the trauma, whatever. This is the death card, the transformation. It's right here underlying. A job, possibly, you're letting go of? I don't know. It's an Ace of Pentacles. Transformation on how you earn money, how you see, how you your worth. I don't know. Whoa, okay. Creation, dawn, the beginning. Why was this reversed? What's going on here for the collective? Some delays, possibly, with the new beginning. That Page of Cups reversed. And the Seven of Pentacles reversed. Look at this Page of Cups in the water here with the fish. This Page of Cups is a young energy, okay? A student. This is why this is reversed here. We're learning about our connection with everything, about what it means to feel abundant, what our emotions are telling us, okay? It's just some resistance to... A Page of Cups is usually an apology. Why are you not forgiving yourself for something? That's what that tells me. Why are you holding yourself in a state of, I'm not worthy to receive? Because it's right here, like knocking at the fucking door. Some indecision with the Seven of Pentacles reversed. Like, why else? Is there anything else besides this Page of Cups that wants to come out for crystal magic? I feel like there's another message. Crystal magic. Just flipped over. The World reversed. That is that not letting go. Wanting to control things is the way I feel. The World reversed. The King of Cups reversed. Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces coming out big time right now. Lots of Cups energy here. And a King of Cups reversed has some trouble balancing his emotions. It's highly emotional. Emotionally manipulative. Coming out reverse. Self-sabotage coming out. And the Tower underneath that now. Reverse. Spirit is trying to help you. Ancestors are trying to help you. When the Tower comes reversed, it's like, this is divine intervention. Your refusal to move forward, your refusal to let go. We are protecting you, child, I hear. And the Page of okay, I'm not going any more into that. If you need your own reading, reach out to me. I can help you. I can give you some wisdom from your guides, from your ancestors, okay? I'm going to leave it there. I don't want to go any deeper into it. The message came out that needed to come out. I love you, love you, love you guys. Take great care of you. Remember, today is a frequency of 10, number 10. One and a zero. Fool energy, taking leaps of faith, taking new steps into the new you, new future you're creating. Okay, and one, new beginning. Trusting yourself, trusting your intuition, trusting your path. The ending is the beginning, so I'll let it end. I love you fucking guys. Bye.